Hey guys, in this video, I'm going to share with you some reasons why I believe that EMS and first responders should wear some kind of body armor when responding to assignments. I gotta warn you, if you work in an area where there's like 50 Starbucks within a 2 mile radius, then you're probably not going to agree with this video. Keep in mind that maybe my opinion has bias because I worked in some of the toughest neighborhoods in the nation. I worked the South Bronx, I worked Harlem, I worked downtown Brooklyn. And I've worked all these areas way before the gentrification. But in my opinion, no matter what area you work, you should be wearing some kind of protection. In case you're interested, in the description down below, I attached some links to some videos and some information about first responders being attacked. The reason number one why I believe that first responders should wear a bulletproof vest or some kind of safety equipment or body armor is because when you knock on somebody's door to reach their apartment or their home to help them because they dialed 911, you have, or we have, no idea what's behind that door. And as EMS and first responders, you guys could definitely vouch for the fact that sometimes you go into somebody's apartment and you are surprised by what you find. May it be a bunch of people, a big mess, or the person's a hoarder. Reason number two is because sometimes the police department is unavailable to help you. Like, for example, recently I was in the projects and there was a loose pit bull within the apartment, and there was an emotionally disturbed person that pretty much was combative, and we needed the police department to come and help us immediately. And they took 20 minutes, not because they didn't want to help us, but because they were busy attending to other calls and maybe they were short-staffed. The reason why we should wear some kind of body armor is because it's the only thing that we could wear or use to defend ourselves, quote-unquote, without it being illegal. Like, for example, if you have a knife that's more than 4 inches in New York State, a firearm, or even pepper spray, it's considered to be illegal. And even though we work side by side with the police department and we are civil servants, we are still held by the same laws that any regular civilian is held. So basically, if you use a knife, a baton, or a pepper spray to defend yourself in the instance where your life is at risk, you're still gonna go to trial. You know what I mean? Like, it's still illegal for you to use those things to defend yourself. I mean, I'm not a lawyer, so I could be mistaken, but I know that from what I've been told is that these things are not to be carried by EMS personnel despite the risk that we're in. And that's why I say this is another reason why we should wear some kind of body armor, because it defends us and it's perfectly legal. Reason number four is because if you get, let's say, a 3A plus vest, this 3A plus vest will help you against bullets, punctures, and even if you get assaulted by a person, let's say, if you have a bulletproof vest on, this vest could help you against getting punched in your stomach or getting punched in your xiphoid process, or even kicked in this area. Like, I used to box, and I know that if you get punched in your xiphoid process, no matter how many sit-ups you do, that's gonna knock the wind out of you. But if you have on one of these vests, it'll be much better than not having anything on at all. Reason number five is because a vest protects some of your most important organs. I mean, every organ in your body is important, but it protects your heart, your lungs, your kidneys, your liver, your spleen, your diaphragm, your stomach, and etc. Sound very important to me, you know what I mean? Reason number six is because sometimes you just don't know whether or not the scene is safe. I mean, we're taught not to proceed into a scene unless the scene is safe. But how many times have you gone into a scene and then realized that it wasn't safe when it was already too late? I know it's happened to me before. An example of when that happened, we got called for the unconscious, and I was working in the South Bronx on New Year's Eve, and this lady had a panic attack. She had a panic attack because her ex-husband was released from jail and he wanted to kill her. She called because she was unconscious, or the neighbors called because she was unconscious. We got there, we found her, we woke her up, and while we were treating her and getting ready to take her to the hospital, someone was at the door. And guess who it was? The gentleman who was released from prison, with a gun in his hand. There was people in the hallway saying, "Don't open the door, he has a gun in his hand," while he was trying to kick down the door. And this was a job I was on where I did not have a bulletproof vest on, but I sure wish I did. So did my partner. But eventually the police department got there, and luckily they took him into custody and nothing happened. Because it increases visibility and it allows for proper identification. Because like my vest, for example, says paramedic in the back and it has the Star of Life and it says EMS in the front. So there's no doubt that I am not a police officer and I'm just there to help. Because depending what area you work or what company or hospital you work for, the EMS uniform is extremely similar to the police department uniform. So you don't want to be confused for a police officer. Reason number 8 is because a lot of the perps that are in the street know that EMS do not carry weapons. And if they don't respect cops, which carry weapons and could take them to jail, how do you think they feel about us? I mean, a lot of them respect us because they know we're there to help and we're the good guys and we're not there to arrest them. But when you have a person who's aggressive, they're going to be much more aggressive towards the person that they know cannot really defend themselves, like the EMS. Reason number 9 is because the majority of time it's just you and your partner, you know, and neither one of us have weapons. We're not even allowed to carry pepper spray. You know, for the in the case of firefighters, usually a fire truck will be staffed by at least 4 to 5 firefighters, probably even more. I haven't really took the time to count it, but I know it's more than 2 of them, unlike us. And police officers, the majority of time, are with their partner, and they both have a baton. They usually have a pepper spray. They have a firearm, and they have a taser. Yet, all we have is just our EMS equipment. Number 10 is because we're the ones in charge of transporting the emotionally disturbed people that are either a threat to themselves or others. I remember a couple years back, I was on a job where the EDP slit his wrist, and then after slitting his wrist with the same knife, he went to attack the BLS crew that was there to help him. And the BLS crew called on the radio for backup, and when we got there, the guy was filled with blood. The BLS crew was like wrestling with the guy. We had to come in and help them. Here's an example of my vest. You have your pouch where you could fit whatever you want. It's pretty big. Here you could fit a lantern and your radio, and it has adjustable straps. And here's the reflective lettering with the Star of Life. And then in the back, you see more reflection. You have adjustable straps, or not straps, but Velcro, so you could adjust to your size. And then it shows my level of training. So this is basically what it looks like on the outside. I usually try to wear it covering it up with a jacket or uniform shirt or a sweater, because I don't want to show up and like try to intimidate anybody or try to act like I'm a police officer. So I usually just cover it up, but this is what it looks like, and it's pretty good. You know, you can move around and provide patient care and it won't disrupt patient care. Although I believe that EMS and first responders should wear some kind of body armor, I don't think you should wear it if you're going to go inside of a nursing home to pick up a ventilator patient. You know what I mean? Like, you don't want to show up to a nursing home all tacticaled out to pick up grandma because she's running a fever. You know what I mean? So you got to, I guess, use your judgment also. I mentioned earlier. Thank you for listening. Thank you for watching. Find me on Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, and please remember to subscribe, share, like, and leave a comment. If you have any requests for any videos that you would like for me to do in the future, please let me know. I'll get to them as soon as possible. And thank you for watching. Peace.